So this is my intro for the footage that I had taken at the exhibit at the Cranbrook Institute of Science called Tutankhamun, Wonderful Things from the Pharaoh's Tomb. I went on a Saturday night on February 11th to go see it. I'm very interested in Egypt and their culture and their symbolism, and and I love there's just so much is like an aura or like a there's just like respect in their culture that I feel like so much more than other places. And this is one of the books that I have that I've had even before the exhibits. And basically this exhibit had replicas, so they weren't like the actual pieces, but it was still a really fascinating exhibit for those that enjoy Egypt culture. The exhibit features 131 replicas of the Pharaoh's possessions and artifacts and a chariot, along with a mummy case and even like a mummy in there itself. I don't actually know if it was odd because it looked like a real mummy. I don't know if it was like a replica of a real mummy, but there was like a little warning sign near it that said that, like, beware of the graphic images, but it could have been just for the, it could have been just for, there's some pictures on the wall that were kind of graphic and not the prettiest pictures in the world. It's open for quite a while until like September 3rd, 2017, so September of this year. There's also some really cool things in this institute, which they had like, there was like no one there. There was like a couple people, but there was like a mineral exhibit and like stones and crystals and just, I'm very much into that, so like I was very much drawn to it. And then I was like walking throughout the whole place, and I ended up going up into this planetarium area, and it was almost like it was like I had walked into another place, like, I didn't even know existed. It was, like, really, really awesome. So, I just wanted to get the right name for it. There was someone that had, like, a telescope. It's not the actual planetarium, but it's called something else, where they have, I think it's the observatory, where they actually, it was like state-of-the-art equipment. The guy that I had talked to didn't even know how much this telescope was, but this guy had been in the field for like years and years. I guess he worked with NASA, and he showed me like a picture of like one of the galaxies. It was really, really like amazing equipment. Like, you could totally see on these two screens like the stars and like different pictures of the galaxy. It's like different tones to it, like either blue or like a pink or like different areas out in the stars. And on Fridays and Saturday nights, it's pretty much opened. So all in all, I'm happy that I went to this exhibit. It kind of brings together Egypt symbolism and culture and kind of brings it to you in this intimate setting. And it kind of makes you think about the way that their culture works. Again, this is more for people that are not so focused on like actually seeing parts and artifacts and things like that. These are definitely replicas. They're not actual artifacts, but for somebody like me that is interested in that time period of, well, way back then, like many, many years ago, with the tombs, and I'm not necessarily interested in like the mummies and the zombies, but more the symbolism, the spirituality that was present in that culture is much stronger than any other culture that I personally know. It kind of brings you back to a different time, even with the replicas, which was really cool. So I would recommend it personally. And I hope everyone enjoys all of the footage that I have. They do allow photos, they do allow video, and that's something that I do appreciate, because there's some places that they don't allow you to tape or take pictures, and I think that kind of limits people's freedom and freedom of the press and freedom of speech, which is what America is about. But I would definitely recommend it, and I hope everyone enjoys and stays punk.
spiritual coach.
One of the most incredible discoveries in the history of archaeology, with a golden treasure that's captured the world's imagination. Long remained unsolved until now. The very latest in digital archaeology, they finally piece together the story of Tut's tomb.
just go out to this lobby and go towards the vending machines.
Yeah.
They